Hey guys, it's Alex with Hammond Watch, here today with the SNK P18. And it's a Seiko 5 that doesn't get a whole lot of play or attention. I don't see it very frequently online. And when I purchased it from Joma Shop, they had it on sale and had dropped the price to like $65. So I had to pick it up and just have a closer look. And I'm pretty satisfied with the watch. I think it's pretty handsome and wanted to share it with you guys today. I really like the watch's sizing. It's a 42 millimeter case. You're looking just over 11 and a half thick, 50 millimeters lug to lug, and it's a 22 millimeter lug width. That strap does taper down to 20 millimeters. You're looking at folded pins, so not the highest quality. But with all the rose gold plating, I think it does have a pretty nice look. Two-button deployant is just under 22 millimeters wide, pressed metal, and as you can see, folded links with a display case back. The case back is showing you the 7S26 movement that powers the watch. It's not a hacking or hand-winding movement. But the trade-off is that you have very long service intervals and a relatively low cost, and then you're operating at minus 20 plus 49 seconds a day. The chocolate brown dial is the star of the show. It's accented with rose gold indices and Romans at 12 and 6. You have an applied Seiko 5 logo and minimal printing with automatic 21 jewels and 50 meters just below the 6. There is a chapter ring that runs a minute track, which I think is very nice and kind of breaks up the simplicity of the dial. You also have a day-date function at 3 o'clock. You'll notice there is Lumabrite in the hands, as well as having small little pips at all of the indices outside of those two Romans. I really like the case design. It's a stepped case, so you have a brushed finish that steps down to a very nice high polish. I think that ties in very well with the polished rose gold plated bezel, as well as the polished rose gold plated center links. Here we are on my 7.5 to 7.75 inch wrist. As you can see, lots of presence with that 50 millimeter lug to lug, but a relatively slim profile. I don't love the strap's quality, but this watch would be a fantastic candidate for something, you know, dark brown and suede. I think it'd be a fun addition to a collection just to kind of mix it up, get a new dial color in there, and also play with some fun gold tones. I like little splashes of rose gold in watches, and it's nice to see it from Seiko at a lower price point. You know, with a lot of the Seiko 5 line that try to look, you know, uber classy, I think this would be best served dressed down in more of a t-shirt and jeans type of environment. But I'm surprised the watch hasn't gotten more attention. You know, it's got a lot of visual interest, and I think it's very, very sharp. If you guys have enjoyed the content, give us a thumbs up. It really helps out in YouTube's algorithm. Also subscribe to the channel. I'm putting watch content out weekly, and hopefully I see you in the next one.